comes by, hearing the word of God. Hearing comes by, listening to the word of God. I pray you get faith the size of a mustard seed and grow. We know that some of you know just what to do with it. Faith comes by, hearing the word.
Is the mic on?
Yes. Praise the Lord, everybody. Welcome back to my channel. So this is a very interesting video. I want to show you, first of all, I want to show you my bag collection. I don't have many, so I just want to show you some of the bags that I own, and then I will tell you what I always keep in my bag, okay? I hope you're going to enjoy this video, and I hope you're keeping safe. I hope you're keeping sane. You make sure you do everything to make sure that you are safe. Your mental health is safe. If you can read the Bible, read. If you can listen to worship, do. If you can listen to sermons, do. If you can go to the club, if you go to the club. I'm not like advocating for, but whatever you can do to make sure your mental health is up to date, is stable, please do it. Okay, all right. So let me start with my cheapest bag. My cheapest bag is this one. This is the cheapest bag. It's written Woman of Faith. Woman of Faith. So this bag, as you can see it, I always carry beside all my bags. It's like a shopping bag. I carry it so that when I window shop on the way from work, wherever I go, I can always, you know, drop my shopping in this bag. So I bought it at 200 shillings only on the streets, but it is very strong and beautiful, and I really love it. It's very spacious. So this is the cheapest bag that I own, but the most favorite. Okay, you see it? This is my cheapest and favorite handbag. All right, so let me go to the next cheapest. The next cheapest is this one. This one I also bought on the streets. This one at 500 shillings only. Imagine, 500 shillings only, guys, only. Yeah, it's very strong. I love it so much. It's a very strong handbag. And it's very spacious also. It's very strong and spacious. This one, I carry it to work most of the time. It's like an official handbag. When you see it, you can't even know it's that cheap. So I bought this at 500 shillings on the streets. If you always walk along Harambe Avenue, if you're Kenyan and you walk along Harambe Avenue, then there's this guy. Actually, there are two, but I know of one very well, the one we transact with. So they sell these handbags, and you know, men, when they sell lady stuff, they always sell them at a throwaway price because they don't know the value. So this was 500 shillings. The next cheapest is this one, this red small handbag. This one, this is the next cheapest. This one I bought at 2000 shillings. This is the next cheapest. I bought it from an Instagram store. I don't know, the guy is called Wes something. Yeah, so this is where I bought it. I love it because it is red. You know, red is beautiful. Red is my favorite color. So this is my next cheapest handbag. And then we go to the next cheapest. I'm using cheap because they're cheap. There are many handbags that are very expensive. So this is the next cheapest handbag, this one, this blue one. I love it so much. I bought it at 2500 shillings in a shop in the streets of Nairobi, and it's very beautiful. The skin is very strong. Like this handbag, I will use it, then I give my child, then my child will give my grandchild, then my grandchild will give my great grandchild. Yes, this handbag is very beautiful. So if you love window shopping, you can always visit Adams Arcade. At Adams, there's a guy also who sells handbags there, and you know, he can always call you when he has new handbags, and that you know, he can even sell at 2,000 shillings, but they're worth the price. All right, now we go to the most expensive handbag. The most expensive handbag. This is my most expensive handbag. I used to have two. Both of them were Prada, as you can see. I used to have two Prada handbags. This one was 5,500 shillings. Actually, I bought it when I was still in the university. Now that is like four years ago. Imagine, I bought it 4 years ago when I was in the university. You see, when you're in the university, you see these good things and you want to own good things. Yeah, so that was when I bought this handbag at 5,000 shillings. 5,000 shillings. So this is my most expensive handbag. I value it so much. It's pink in color. It's beautiful. It stands out everywhere I go. I love it. It's spacious also. I love it. So I'm going to... Okay, the last handbag. The last handbag is this one. So this one, I love carrying it to church on Sunday. Yeah, because I can always just put my offering inside only, and my notebook. As you can see, I have my church notebook here. So I carry it to church on Sunday. This one. Fave. This is my Sunday bag. Okay, so let me go next to the theme of this, to the headline or to the title, to the whatever, to the topic of today. Okay, so the topic of today was, what is inside my handbag? So the first thing that is inside my handbag is my water bottle, because a girl has to hydrate. So the first thing is my water bottle. My water bottle is always in my handbag, because the jam in Nairobi is serious. So when I'm leaving to work, I have water inside. When I'm leaving work home, I have water inside. So the first thing that I own in my handbag every day is my water bottle. This one, I depend on this one fully. Why? Because I do running, morning runs and evening runs. And let me tell you, if you're not hydrated, then you will feel the pinch when you're running. When you are fully hydrated, then you also feel the swag, the comfort, the joy while running, okay? All right, the next thing that I carry in my handbag is my handkerchief. My handkerchief, because a girl has to dust off. A girl has to dust off. So the next thing I have is my handkerchief, which depending, you know, if it is used, I can always replace. It's not like I replace every day. So this is the next thing that I have in my handbag, my handkerchief. Next, because of Corona, we always carry extra mask inside the handbag. So I carry my mask extra in case. You see, this mask, most of the time they tear from here. So anytime when it tears, a girl cannot walk without a mask, because a girl has to protect herself. So I have an extra mask in my handbag. Next, my notebook. This notebook contains, you know, my bank accounts. It contains my, you know, the bank accounts of the bills that I make. It also contains people's measurements. Like, I always make dresses for my mom, for my grandma. So I have people's measurements inside here. I love giving gifts. So I have also the sizes of shoes of the people that I gift. And it also has my passwords. Yeah. Yeah, it has some phone numbers that I've not saved on my phone. Yes, yeah, because people like prying into your private affairs, so their numbers I've not saved. But once you call and I get a missed call, I come to my notebook and find out who was that. Then I can call you back knowing your name, especially people from work. Your phone numbers is saved on my notebook, not on my phone. All right, next is my Bible. My Bible is the next thing that has to be inside my handbag, and it is marked. It is marked. Yeah, so at times I read my Bible, in the matatu. I read my Bible over lunch hour. Any moment I get to spend with God, I take. So I always carry my Bible inside my handbag. Not my handbag inside my Bible. My Bible inside my handbag, okay? Next, my wallet. This is my wallet. So it contains all the dollars. Yeah. Yeah, so my money is inside here. So you see, this is 500 shillings. If you came to Kenya like 10 years ago, we have new money. Yeah, so this is my wallet, and my wallet is always inside my handbag because I have to pay my fares, I have to window shop, so I have to have excess money. No, just enough. Yeah, next is my makeup bag. This is my makeup bag. It contains my moisturizer, it contains my foundation, it contains my lipstick, it contains my glycerin, it contains my powder, yeah. It contains my face brush, but I'm not on makeup right now. When I'm at home, I don't do makeup. Most of my videos, I don't do makeup. Yeah, so I also have my makeup bag inside my handbag. Although the foundation that I use doesn't run out. No, it doesn't run. This one, it's like 9,000 shillings from Linton's pharmacy in town. So it's off Moy Avenue. It doesn't run out. So I never touch up, but at times I'm late and I don't do my makeup at home. I go and do my makeup at work, yeah, or at times I'm late for an event, I just go to that event, look for a washroom, do my makeup, because there's no difference between my natural, there's no big difference, because I do very minimal makeup, just to make sure that, you know, I'm smooth, and baby skin. What's next? And the last thing that I carry inside my handbag is my keys, my room keys, my house keys. This one is always, I open my door, then I return it inside my handbag. We are coming to the end of this video, guys. We are coming to the end of this video, but one more last thing. Essential. This is essential services. Yeah, so my phone is always inside my handbag. Okay, it's either on my hands or it is inside my handbag. So I always walk with my phone, because my phone also has a place that has notes. I keep some notes, like my sermons are here. Anytime I get an idea, I write my sermons on my notes, you know, on the keypad note. Yeah, so my, like, this phone contains like everything that is inside my notebook. My phone and my notebook are almost like they substitute each other. Whatever my notebook has, my phone has. But there are things that my notebook has that my phone does not have. There are things that my phone has that my notebook does not have. Enough of that, guys. I hope you've enjoyed this video. Also tell me, what is it that you think I need to add on my You know, we've not finished. Guys, will understand this. Girls, you will understand this. At times, you wear like your dress well, and then you get to work, and then boom. This is an essential. Your dress tears. So I have this needle. Yeah, so I sort myself with this. Ouch, it has pricked me. Yeah, so I sort myself with this at work. Anytime when I hear, just run to the washroom and sort it out and fix it. Girls have to fix it. Yeah. Yeah, and I know you're wondering why I'm not, you know, my sanitary towels are not inside my handbag or my, what are they called? Sanitary towels, the other one that, you know, the small one, whatever, I've forgotten the name. But it's not all the time that I carry them, because my over time, my periods have been regular, so I know when to carry and when to not. So I don't carry it in my handbag all the time. I carry it towards my period time. That's when you get it inside my handbag. But on a daily basis, what I've showed you is what I carry inside my handbag. Okay, I hope you've enjoyed this video. Okay, all right. If you need a plug, if you need the phone numbers, if you're in Nairobi and you need the phone numbers of the people who sold me these handbags, both in the streets and in, you know, in the town, in the shops, you can leave a comment on the comment section below. If you need to gift me a handbag, you can also leave a comment, because I still need more handbags. All right, but I'm satisfied for now. I don't like much. I'm more of a minimalist. Okay, the Lord bless you so much. Keep safe. Love the Lord. Any little time that you get, make sure you are reading your Bible, you are listening to worship, you are drawing closer to God, because the Bible says, draw closer to me and I will draw closer to you. That is how it works. You know how it works? Yeah. See you again next time. Goodbye. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button. Hit the subscribe button. Bye.
Faith comes by hearing the word of God. Hearing comes by listening to the word of God. I pray you get faith the size of a mustard seed.